Indian students and the Semester at Sea students are intermingling here and talking about what their different experiences are in finding out about each other while having displays of dance and really good food and all of the Indian culture.
Thank you.
I got involved in Semester at Sea when I was a professor in a college. So I thought it's a good idea to get the Indian students to have a chance to meet with the students who come on the Semester at Sea, and the Semester at Sea students also will have a good chance to mix with the Indian students, pick up lifelong friends, and also it's much easier for them to talk to each other and get to know more about the country from boys and girls of their own age.
What is this?
Vada. Vada, vada.
Family, culture. We talked for a while about marriage for some of them and how in a couple of years guys' parents are all going to find them wives. And actually seeing how a bunch of these guys are going to know their future wife for a total of about an hour for setting a marriage date, it's a very different cultural experience.
I moved here about 5 years ago and I just decided I need to start a band. So I started Tango Pacifico. And we flew in a bandoneon player, a friend of mine from Denver that I used to play with. And then there was a guy named Alex Krebs in town who teaches tango, and he wanted to form a tango group, and he was learning bandoneon, and we formed a group together about 3 years ago.
The building was built in 1968, and it was at a time when there were about 60,000 people in Clark County. So the community feeling was that we had a dog pound, and it was where dogs came when they were stray, and that was pretty much it. You came here to pick your dog up, and if you didn't get them, then you know, more than likely they were going to be euthanized. Last year we handled over 13,000 animals. The Humane Society offers over 24 programs to the community, including adoptions, volunteer opportunities, a foster program, and all animals that are adopted from here are either spayed or neutered and have a microchip. This organization has known for many years that we've needed a new facility. I mean, looking at the building, you can tell that it needs to be renovated and we need new spaces. In 1968, Clark County had 60,000 people. It's now exploded to 350,000 people, and we're in the same building.
My cat's name is Ringo.
She is a purebred Mexican street dog.
So this is the mellow cat.
And she loves food.
Come here. Well, other than his stunning good looks, he definitely has the activity level that I can handle.
See, he'll open the back door.
Oh, you're all the way up.
This cat was a terror for about 7 years.
Two high fives. Good boy.
Come here.
I just feel blessed because so many people are missing so much and not having an animal, and especially people that are alone or older, or they need something to love. They have to have something to love. Isn't she beautiful? She's so wonderful.
Most voyagers make the trip to visit Hiroshima. The Industrial Promotion Hall was intentionally left standing by the Japanese government as a stern reminder about the ultimate consequence of nuclear power.
In a nuclear age, nuclear war class, after Brazil, Professor Murphy had us write an essay about whether or not we thought the dropping of the bombs in Hiroshima and Nagasaki was justified. And I did, because I said it would save like 20, 30,000 American lives.
On August 6th, 1945, just 3 days before Nagasaki was hit, a United States bomber flew overhead, dropping a device that ultimately killed 200,000 people and injured many more.
Just to see the charred clothing and stand at the hypo center and realize that 40, 50 years ago, that the destruction, the people that were evaporated in the middle of the town. I don't imagine how I could argue that anymore.
So I visited the Memorial Park in Nagasaki, and so I was a little prepared, but still, I think when I got here, I forgot how much it had impacted me then, and so it was pretty intense to see it all over again and to think that we as Americans as a whole were a part of that and had something to do with it in some way.
For me, the main thing that it meant was that the war was over. And I had relatives who were fighting in the Pacific, and so it was a pretty happy bit of news that that bomb had fallen and that war was over, and of course it's far more complicated than
that. I think that the Japanese probably don't look down upon us, but if I were in their shoes, like, maybe I would, you know? Just it'd be kind of hard to have, you know, the people that actually did this come, you know, visit the site. But I think they realize now that we're coming in memorial and that, you know, we realize what we did was wrong.
We know about it, but going to see
firsthand,
you know, what happened just gives you a totally different perspective.
And Nagasaki's pretty much all built up. You can't really find very many remains except for the Peace Park and the museum. And here they have buildings like this that are still perfect remains of what happened. It's not completely built over. You can still see the scars.
This has truly been the most foreign adventure of my trip. Halfway through, the profound wake-up call for all of us was appropriate.
In America, it seems like if we talk to people from other countries, we ask them, what do you think of America? We identify ourselves with the country. And here was a man identifying himself with a people.
But our cab driver seemed to think it would be a really good idea for us to do some drive-by holy shootings. And I just hosed him down. I got all six of them. So then they slow down. They go ahead and pull a Yui. And they come back and we're still shooting him. They go out with open arms.
Get to this little shack that was about 6 foot by 6 foot with a concrete pad and reed walls and a reed roof. And we go inside and there's his five sons sleeping on the floor and his wife sitting there on the floor watching this little teeny black and white TV.
कर डगरिया रहना ये रसते तरसते हो तू आ जा रे इस धरती का है राजा तू ये बात जान ले तू कठिनाई से टकरा जा तू नहीं हार मान ले तू मितवा सुन मितवा तुझको क्या डर है रे ये धरती अपनी है अपना अंबर है रे ओ मितवा सुन मितवा तुझको क्या डर है रे धरती अपनी है अपना अंबर है